That wasn't too bad, all things considered. That could have been a much nastier fight. I love it. The boss fight has been the easiest thing we've done in this place. Jesus Christ. I am very thankful that when we killed him, all of the possessed sorcerers just kind of gibbed themselves. His amulet. Constitution, fire resistance, necromancer, and reflects melee damage as fire damage. As well as a key. I'm exactly where that necklace is going, too. Assuming it's an upgrade. Mm-hmm. Not really, but yeah, kinda. We'll give it to her. Well, let's see, what is this? Strength, retribution, bartering, and persuasion. Nah, I want him to have leadership. Upgrade for fame, though. Okay. Let's loot some bodies. Actually, let's heal. Yeah, you are not wrong. Retribution seems very powerful, and I actually kind of like that. It's a hymnal, the taming of the holy fire. Graceful script and precise musical notation decorate each page of this beautifully bound hymnal. Not every scholar could comprehend its meaning, but we are able to decipher it. So that's probably something important, so we're going to take it. I'm a huge fan of Charming Arrowhead. I'm a huge fan of how, like, they actually, like, even though, like, the Red Prince doesn't fight really well, like, things that beat on him suffer for it. And, like, with taunts, he's able to force things to beat on him. It's actually, like, as much as I hate giving 4th edition D&D any props, that's one thing that they did really well with their, like, tanky type classes, is that you could really punish enemies, like, when you'd marked them or whatever. What is the... Oh, we can climb that. That if you'd, like, marked something, you could punish the shit out of it if it didn't do what you wanted it to. Wait a minute. Formation. Yeah, that they let you do preset party formations. I don't know how useful that is, realistically. Okay, so how do we know... How do we know what the front of the party is? It's like my ideal would be something like... Essentially this. Let's see what this does. Use positions at the start of combat. So now if I do this, will they... Oh my gosh! Wow! That's... Huh. That's pretty cool. Yeah, like, I understand that it's a very MMO thing. And I love these poison fries. I understand that it is a very MMO thing to do that, where you can, like, have taunts and stuff, but at the same time, it's a good way to make, like, the fighter types have utility in combat besides, you know, I hit a guy. Now it's like, I hit a guy, but also if that guy hits somebody that's not me, like, I wreck his day up. But yeah, I can see how it's like, it doesn't make necessarily a lot of sense from a why standpoint. So what's up here? Yeah, exactly. Like, that's the thing. I mean, even, like, 3rd edition, they had rules for, like, using Intimidate to taunt people in combat. And, like, I don't know. I don't see why there's anything necessarily wrong with being able to use, like, a class ability to force somebody to attack you or whatever. There's some class for... I think it's Pathfinder, maybe. Can't remember what it's in. I think it's called the Armiger, though. It might be the Path of War, where, like, they have a marking thing, and it's, like, it's a penalty where if...
Mordus turned the key into an amulet.
No! Did that take the amulet permanently? Oh, man! Oh, no, I just put it back in our inventory. Okay. But they have a thing where you, like, mark a target, and anytime that target does, like, anything against someone that isn't you, like, whether it's an attack roll or whatever, it suffers, like, a penalty for it. And it starts off at, like, a -2, and by, like, high levels, it's, like, -6 or -8. So it's, like, super punishing. And I'm like, yeah, that's pretty cool.
And I thought this cave couldn't get any more grim.
It's just a chest, dude. How grim could it be?
I know what that smell is.
Magic.
Death, most likely. Watch your step.
Raucous ring. May be useful. Ice wall. And a wizard's mantle. Strength, geomancy, and necromancy. Fuck it, is that even four? Strength, geomancy, and necromancy. Jesus God. On mage armor. There's gotta be like death. Oh.
Look out. I see a trap nearby.
Yep. I don't even know what's going on. Get out of the water. I don't like that one bit. Get in the water. We'll save, and then we'll get in the water. Oh no. Is that more fiery death? Yes, no? I don't like that it's saving. That worries me so much. Alright. So what is this? Just a dead dwarf. A velvety pouch, a skin sack for storing coordinates, dice, and apparently small body parts. Taste of freedom. What was that? What? Taste of freedom. Oh, okay, so this dude has the gem. Okay, so we just found the gemstone eye in that gem, there in that sack, apparently. Jesus, alright, that was like I would have never been like, hey, let's go into some random death cramp dungeon, and that's where the eye will be. I don't know. Oh no. We've been attacked by a boat. What the fuck? We're like the Goonies now. A boat just came slamming out of the wall, and we're being accosted by crabs and a shark. I mean, it's a unique encounter. I gotta give him that. Morning, McMurder Pants. Welcome. I hope you were doing well today. Curious to see how nasty this shark is gonna be. I'm not gonna lie. I also like this music. Are the crabs on our side? I think the crabs might be neutral. I have no idea. Love how our undead warrior is still here, but he doesn't get an— oh no, yeah, he does get an action. I was gonna say. I apparently needed a bigger boat! Yes! Absolutely! We were just doing water things, and then all of a sudden— that crab is dynamite! I don't know what it's doing. Okay, they're neutral, alright. So yeah, they're just chilling out. Crabs just doing crab things. I can respect that. You do you. Crabs, I'm sorry for nailing you with crippling spells early on. I thought you wanted to eat my face off. Skeleton, you can just move up here, I guess. They flee from the shark because they are wise. Alright. Rove. I mean, open up with a fireball, because of course. Holy hell, this thing's got some defenses on it. Alright, in that case... I am going to haste... Where's Beast at? Haste Beast. I'm gonna teleport Beast. He'll take a little damage from this, but it'll get him up in the melee. And I guess that's it. Alright, Beast. You're gonna get close enough and you're gonna wreck this thing's face, ain't you, buddy? Yeah, you are. Okay, he's got 3 AP. Can we do anything trolly with this? Maybe. Alright, so this thing can't move now, so at least it can't eat like my back row. It hits pretty hard. It's pretty hard indeed. Fane. Lightning bolt the water. Yes. Yes, surely that won't end in sadness. I can see nothing going wrong if we backstab or if we lightning bolt the water. Absolutely. Okay, we'll taunt it, and I'm gonna have the Red Prince jump behind it. I still think that is a really cool animation for an attack. I just like the, anything that reminds me of, like, dragoons from Final Fantasy is cool in my book. Okay, Losa. I mean, you can just turn it into a frog. And then just encourage everybody. I think that's all you need to do. Ifin. Pin it. And then arrow.
Focus.
Damn it, Ifin. One job. Aid me in combat, Crab. You got this. Crab's moving in for melee. A crab is out for blood. The others are just kind of looking busy, though. Don't go in the fire. Don't go in the fire. Don't. Oh man, they're moving into grant flanking bonuses. It's at least a +2 to hit right there. This shark is having a bad day. I can tell you that much. Okay, be within range now. Okay, let's move Rove in. It's that damn crab, probably. Wow. Holy shit, whoa, the phoenix fucked that thing up. Huh. Interesting. Alright, well, that was... Sure, that was a thing. Now we have to get out of here. Which is all gonna be up to Ifin. Taking down the hull here. Yeah, that was certainly a unique battle, I'll give them that. I don't think I've ever been in a dungeon in a video game and had a ship crash through a wall and then been attacked by a shark. That's very, like, old-school D&D. It speaks to me, and I smile for it as opposed to the rest of the pit. Okay, why didn't I leave? That worries me. Nope, get away from it. Okay, game. I just need to move people one at a time. Yes, okay. Apparently I had too many people there. Weird. We all here. 1, 2... Yes. We're missing the undead warrior. Who can act on his own but cannot use a ladder. Farewell, undead warrior. We knew ye well. What is that? What is that? A hole? Yes. I have no idea where this is up where Fane started. Interesting. And there's like a fast transport hole to get out. Weird. As well as a chest with some loot. Bride's Bane, Constitution, ooh, Aerotheric, and Summoning. Tentatively useful. God, we are gonna have to do inventory management at some point. I've got so much crap. That is a lot of Constitution. Well, small ring, I dare say you have been replaced. Okay, we gotta start shoring up Beast's hit points. For a frontliner, he is pretty squishy. Losa's actually catching up with the Red Prince, though she very much lacks his constitution.
A letter with a dwarf seal.
Fine paper.
Lohar! Isbael's agents inform her that the death fog is in your possession. It must be delivered to Arx with all possible speed. I do not know what is causing this delay, but I do not know.
Great gilded galleons, what's it say?
I'm trying to read it, but you guys keep interrupting me. I don't know what's causing the delay, but I do know that you will rectify this unfortunate error. I'm sure you know the penalty for disobedience. Do not disappoint me, your queen. So it looks like the dwarves are trying to make death fog.
Death fog. Nasty stuff. Overkill for a bunch of scattered rebels, though. Justinia's stooping lower than even I thought possible.
Could there be any other explanation?
Hard to say. That mad doctor Isbael's the one who pulls the Queen's strings. No idea who's pulling hers. All I know is that we don't want death fog catching a ride on the roaring Ark's winds. Long as that stuff's around, no one's safe.
Okay. Good to know. Oh, an unsent reply. Mother dearest, I'll finally make you and Daddy proud. I've got a job. I'm not quite sure what I'll be doing yet, but I'll be working for another dwarf called Mortis in the Driftwood area. I'm sure it will be productive, interesting, and useful labor. I'll send some coin home as soon as I get paid. All my love, Stife. Well, I don't know how that worked out for her, but all right. Let's loot the books. Phoenix Dive skill book. Actually, does he does. Does he not meet? Oh, it's Warfare 2. Shit. I could teach it to Losa, but I would like to teach this to Beast, actually. On his next level, I think I'm going to give him another point of Warfare. Because he needs a movement skill. I think he's the only one in the party that doesn't have a movement skill of any sort. And I am all for mobility. Okay. An interesting little aside there. Now we have things to do, though. Like, we want to get back to town, and we want to pop that, that eye into that statue that we found. Let's see what's in the obvious secret door that it's next to. So are we where I think we are? Yeah, we totally are. We are suffering frame rate because saving. Yeah, this is where we were earlier, where I said I bet we can teleport down here. Nice! And yeah, this is totally a waypoint statue. Wonderful.
The statue reaches blindly upwards, her face tear-streaked with trickles of rainwater, and her wings pockmarked by the salty spray of the sea.
Touch the statue.
You no longer look without, but within. You understand where your path must take you.
Okay, so yeah, there's the cove, and then the other one is in the depths of Wrecker's Cove. A nasty fucking dungeon. Okay, is there anything out here? Ooh, what is this? Oh, there's a hatch. Can you... Oh. It's in the hatch. Is this seriously? It's a fucking dungeon. What is this? Oh, is that? I think that might be Death Fog. Yeah, that's Death Fog. Instant wreck of the peacemaker. Instant death for the living. For the living. Which technically, Thane is undead. Not even gonna reply to that. Note found on shipwrecked Magister corpse. Magister, your detachment has been chosen for your loyalty. The cargo is in your charge. Make sure it reaches its destination intact. Do not open the cargo. Do not allow the captain or her crew to open the cargo. The cargo is important. Protect it with your life. Yoink. Does it kill him? Oh, he's totally immune to death fog. Fuck yeah. What is this? Haze. Haze all characters in the area, causing a persistent mist to follow them and obscure vision. Ooh. While haze, targets have reduced air resistance, which is meh, but a penalty to accuracy, and it's arrow fear, which that's rove. Where is Fame? Learn that. I don't know if he has any, I was gonna say, yeah, I don't think he's got any skill slots, but that'll be pretty useful, I think. I don't really, he doesn't have anything that I would trade out. Maybe, no, Fire Whip's got the blindness on it, which is really, really good. Although this is only 1 AP, shit. Game is making me make choices. No, we'll hold off. I'll give it to him when he's got, next level, I'll grab him some extra memory. So, it should be a little better. All right, I would like that amulet. Lore Master, Leadership, and Lucky Charm. Oh, can I not? Can't get over there? Can I? It's a pretty cool skill, you guys.
Nice.
Lore Master, Leadership, and Lucky Charm. Well, I mean, that it's got leadership on it makes me want to throw it. The Red Prince. But Lore Master and Lucky Charm, like Lucky Charm makes me want to give it to Ifin because he's our luck monger. Get him up to a 7. I don't know how good that is though, like that's a thing. And also he'd be losing finesse and range, which is important to him. Rove, what is your amulet? Pyrokinetic. Increase your damage against ignited enemies. I love it. The effect is double. You are also on fire. I actually think I'm going to give this to Rove. Losing a point of Pyroconnect doesn't hurt him that badly, I don't think. And the extra point into Lore Master is nice because he is a Lore Master, yeah. Alright. Well, was an interesting little aside. I like that, like, this is something that somebody could totally miss. Like, even thinking to get over here. Not us. And now instead of teleporting people across one at a time, we'll just do that. We'll be on our way. With another quick save, because I am, like, hellishly paranoid about everything. Though I can't imagine anything out here is going to be as nasty as the stuff that we bumped into in there. It also looks like there's no way out of here, like, on land. So I think we're expected. Yeah. That's nasty looking. I think we're just expected to teleport out. Okay. Let's go back to town. Oh, let's see. I think we have to go this way. Yes, I think it was this house that had the basement. I love how that dwarf, like, the corpse is still sitting there smoldering. After all this time. Okay. So let's see what this is.
Perfect fit.
And it's another hatch. Okay. Don't, like, this isn't Baldur's Gate. But it wouldn't surprise me if I'm being honest. Oh. We have a, I bet you this is a button puzzle right here. Just gonna poke around really quick.
It's broken.
See if there's anything. There is not. Alright. Alright. This door is, I assume, magically locked. Why is it letting the Red Prince pick this? Can't be picked. Okay, can we destroy the door? No, no health bar. Alright. Oh, alright, game. Oh, is this one of those... I just have to position my party on this such that they light everything up. What happens if they're both... Well, then it makes fuck. Oh no. This is gonna be a nightmare, isn't it? It's like, there's all water. And ain't doing shit. I love it, the mini-map's just like, hey guys, puzzle. Time stops when Kaku Demon forget to cast protection or evil, get eaten. Yeah. That's something that, if I recall correctly, they carried that forward into Neverwinter Nights 2, or Neverwinter Nights as well, didn't they? Where if you cast a gate and you didn't have protection from evil, the Baelor would attack you. Does my quest log have anything? The magistrates list several sorcerers who may help us master our system. That's no use at all! They did? Awesome. I thought I remembered that. We found a strange and elaborate puzzle. It would be wonderful if I had any, like, source of reference as to what the fuck this was. So my thinking then is, do these have more than two? No. Because the thing to remember is that, like, this is a puzzle that has to be solved by four characters, so we shouldn't need to use extras for this. At the same time, like, I have no frame of reference about what this... Oh no, there are other ones. Okay, well in that case... How many of the ones? Okay, so that gets rid of them. No idea. Yeah, I'm thankful that, like, we're not, like, being ganked by anything here, yes. I am in agreement with that, at the very least. but at the same time, having no idea whatsoever